first talk that we have today is called Harnessing Byzantine Fault Tolerance Using Classical Theory. And my name is Dr. Thaddeus Westerson.
Hi, my name is Dr. Mark Sarkawi. I'm from American Freedom University. The title of my talk today is about a system we built called JOG. And it's about synthesizing checksums and lambda calculus using our system. It's kind of a revolutionary type system, so that's why we have this icon here on the screen. Feel free to interrupt with questions if anyone has any questions.
So the work that I'm going to be talking about today is a study of Ethernet, which we all know so well and use on a daily basis.
Okay, let me start with some motivation. We all know that operating systems, the trends in operating systems have been proving that write-back caches and meta model are typically more typical than ever. The problem is that current researchers in this field of operating systems and lambda calculus do not typically understand the essential problems involved in things like crypto analysis. And this has actually been an issue in recent years.
The reason there's a box of package on the front is it's sort of a cliche analogy, but one which, you know, I'll use anyway. You know, if you have this box, which is Ethernet, and it's wrapped in brown paper, the brown paper of various protocol details. And the question is, when you unwrap the box and you open the box, what do you find inside?
So in this talk, we're going to be talking about JOG, which is a novel system that we designed for the refinement of consistent hashing.
Just a brief outline of the talk that I'm going to give.
First, the overview of the linked list is in terms of the UNIVAC computer, which is a very kind of prototypical computer from a long time ago.
Then we'll do some more experimental evaluation. Then we'll give you a hypothesis.
Then we have results. The results are hopefully going to be interesting.
Present the measurement study that we conducted and then conclude.
Past studies show that as we network our clients together, that it's really thin clients that we care the most about. And kind of the more full-featured, thick clients that might have a lot of linked list technology behind it really doesn't kind of, it's not really reflected in the past studies.
We need epistemologies that are symbiotic. Symbiotic, flexible, and also in a large scale, that will operate on a large scale.
And usually it runs in about big omega of n time. And this is obviously a problem for performance.
The usual solution that's presented for this sort of problem is simply to add access points. And this is a solution that actually works, but it's not that interesting.
We assume that all adversaries in the system are going to be behaving childlike.
You know, that might not seem too topical to what we're addressing here, and we want to keep this talk as topical as possible.
We're going to assume also that they're technologically impaired.
I'm going to be talking about a different approach, which I will show doesn't work, but may work someday.
So the question we asked ourselves up at American Freedom University is, how can we make these efficient modalities more secure?
So this slide didn't really come out too well.
Okay, here's a diagram of our architecture.
It looks almost linked list-like in that, you know, there are a couple of weird cycles in there. And this is what would happen if, you know, you had a linked list that really was more towards things other than thin clients. And we really want thin clients.
You see here that there's an internet cloud here in the middle. You have many devices connected to each other and also connected through the internet. You also have several peripheral devices, such as USB keys.
This slide really did not turn out too well. You know, we have a bunch of different computers being networked. And floppy disks, as usual, they're not really as important as they used to be. With the lock, they're really trying to show how cryptographers were thinking about thin clients in the past.
E is connected to J. J and G are mutually connected. But the problem, of course, is that G must be connected to itself, which is simply an impossibility.
Okay, let's talk.
Would you like some water, Dr. Krishnan?
There's some water up here.
Please.
I'm sorry.
I see the results here are really kind of preliminary.
While the system is infeasible in practice and largely infeasible in theory.
For the application binary interface, as seek time goes up, we actually see the iterate route go up for B-trees, but not for web browsers, although there is a lot of noise in that data.
What would happen if our web browsers could be made lazily discrete? This could be done simply these days with a plug-in.
There's not much sense in this data, as we can tell, but it kind of has good impact on simplicity.
So here we have a graph of simulated results, and this is a CDF, which means it's hard to read.
And you know, this is kind of normalized for some other things that you normally don't see. So it's not the regular exponential curve that we hear so much about.
So here we deployed 31 old Macs across a 10-node network, which in itself involves some tricky wiring. Why did we use Macintoshes? We got a good deal.
Maybe I should have done this at the beginning of the talk because I think it was a little confusing, but I'm going to go over related work now.
It's a lot of related work, I know, because sometimes I get overwhelmed by it too.
Obviously, there's the work of, in 1997 on automata that are structured, not simply just structured, but extremely structured.
Of course, Dijkstra's seminal paper in the Journal of Sign Symmetries in 1999 obviously influenced Jog a great deal.
That's actually not that relevant, but it's on the slide anyway.
Super pseudorandom models, which I don't really have to explain how this relates to our work.
In conclusion, I've presented Scherzo. I have to figure out how to pronounce the name of our own system.
I talked about Jog, which is has a little bit to do with digital analog converters, although I didn't talk about it in this talk. You can read the paper for more information about that.
This is a futile effort, but one which we believe is valuable nonetheless.
We show that Jog is able to cache virtual algorithms.
And in doing so, it prevents the World Wide Web.
You know, we have more results in the paper. So that's about it, and thank you.
Our application represents a minor contribution to the theory. Thanks.
Scarcely attended as it was.
Yeah, I think we'll be dangerously underfunded next year.
Yeah, so we really have to reevaluate our whole project. It turns out that perhaps the market for randomly generated papers is not as... the audience is not as great as we thought it was.
and then people might actually want to hear something of substance.